I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters. And no one ever leaves.
Girl. We've got a daughter, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby girl.
Oh, James. We did it. Oh, daughter. Oh, our beautiful daughter.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, sweetie. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. Your daddy, sweetheart. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about?
Thank you.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. Going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, beautiful. Just like her daddy.
It's a big world out there, honey, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
She's in cardiac arrest. Start compression.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay, just 1 minute. We need a doctor, not a dead witness. Fail to meet my expectations.
Now there will be trouble.
James and his cheery charity.
Decorations.
They are future
the right
boys.
This place will feel just like home.
Don't look straight into the light, honey. You'll hurt your eyes. It's just something you get used to down here.
Come on over here, sweetie. Come on. Walk to Daddy. You can make it. You can do it. There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You will be okay, honey. I'll be back in a bit. Quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the... Love that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? She is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, honey. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young lady. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You will be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're such a liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday? Gross! I didn't think you even liked boys. Especially not Freddy the Freak. Yuck. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who'd rather curl up with Grognak the Barbarian than Freddy Gomez. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
Happy birthday, Missy.
Are you having an... I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. That's not what I hear. But perhaps she'll set a good example for you. There's still plenty of time for you to make something of yourself.
Are you having a nice
Isn't
time?
Isn't this great?
Attention, everyone!
Hey,
it's
happy birthday, Nosebleed!
Andy, wait!
How's it going, sweetheart?
Nice party.
Oh, no!
I am mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
Nice party, butthead. Now get lost before I have to make...
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Daddy,
so, what do
you
think we should call our guest?
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What?
Nonsense.
Is your best
People
friend now?
Always enjoy
hey,
my
Wally,
speech.
I think Paul's enough.
Besides, that friend of yours could use
hey,
a little
bit
of
light.
Not at all.
Get him
on a game. He needs to go around all day being called a
fool. Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young lady you are. Don't ever lose your gift of speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go, a nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday girl. No sharing required today.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Oh, yeah? We'll see about that. You're gonna be sorry, you little... Say, Uncle!
Do you think you surprised her?
Butch, what are you
doing?
Sure. Hitting a girl, and on her birthday, for heaven's sakes.
Now go on.
Come on,
Georgia,
honey. You always have...
Yeah, I got one.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? A
can't believe you tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Jeez, Wally, who's the head of the gang? You or me? No way!
Thanks for coming, Stanley. I know you were busy with the water purifier. Everything's fine, I hope.
Oh, I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
I wasn't worried. You can fix anything, right? Anyway, I'm glad you could make it.
All right, Butch.
Are you having a nice time?
How are you
hey,
enjoying the party,
Officer
Mr. Palmer?
Gomez.
I helped with the decorations.
Come on,
you
guys
can
do better than that.
I've had it with you,
that.
Butch.
We need
your
a
mother's
good
going
name.
To hear about this little incident.
They're lovely.
You're so smart.
Why don't you,
you
suspend the job?
Nice. Hello, party. Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
I'm glad to be here. I
Another
think it's important to keep
well
in touch with the young
way,
people, you know,
as
part of my job. Plus, well, I like parties.
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I wish we didn't have to invite him, but there just aren't that many children your age in the vault. In any case, you'll have to learn to deal with bullies. The world is full of people much worse than Butch, I'm afraid. But don't let him ruin your birthday. Go on. I bet there's someone else waiting to give you a present.
Sure thing, Officer Gomez. Well, it's been nice chatting with you.
How do you like that there Pip-Boy, miss? Fit all right and everything? Of course it is, just like everybody else's. They don't make them anymore now, do they? That one I've been saving just for you, though. The A-Series is a bit heavier than some of the fancier models, but it won't let you down. I bet you could drop a bomb on one, and it would still work. As a matter of fact, I know you could. Sure, most people don't give a thought to their Pip-Boy as long as it keeps working. Well, anyway, I got this for your birthday. It isn't much, and you probably already have one. But there you go. Happy birthday.
Ooh, I like that, Butch.
Nice party.
I don't know. Maybe.
Happy birthday, Missy.
Happy birthday.
Why are you still hanging around?
Jonas?
Hey, Doc. We're all set down here.
Thanks. I'll send her right down.
I got it.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
How about Hell's Overseers? Yeah, I like that.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. Oh, you are so funny. 10 years old, of course you are. Why, you have your Pip-Boy and everything. And you know what I did, just for the occasion? Wrote you a poem. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Just be patient. You don't want to ruin the surprise, do you?
Maybe.
Go ahead. Jonas is waiting.
That's a good one.
What are you doing down here, young lady? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The overseer gave you your Pip-Boy. You're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me. Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him. Careful, it's a rat roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine. Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a GOAT to take. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the GOAT. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, sweetie. I got out of here. Good luck.
morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
The odds of a Vault-Tec shelter failing are...
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
What do you want? None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me? Maybe you're right. We can deal with her later. Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Hey, Susie, what's new?
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. You don't want to be the first class in history to fail the goat, do you?
Back off!
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Eight. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number one. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person involved 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants. It's nice to know I can still be surprised. Pedicurist. Might have guessed manicurist, or even masseuse, but apparently, you're a foot person. Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously. Look where I ended up. Just between you and me, the whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Get out of my face. We'll talk to your little friend later.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Anything's possible, even an egg.
That is the promise you can take now. If you get back to work. Selfish and insolent.
You need to know these things.
Wake up! Come on, wake up! Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you. You don't understand. Your dad somehow opened the main door and left the vault. My father, I've never seen him so angry. Listen to me. If the guards find you, they'll kill you. It's Jonas. They killed him. My father's men. They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, it's lucky I got here ahead of them. But we can't stand here talking. You've got to get out of here. I'm sorry, but... I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. We don't have time for this! Trust me, security doesn't know about the tunnel. Just my father and me. Maybe this pistol I stole from my father will make you feel better. Go ahead, take it. And then let's get out of here. I hope you're joking. Even with that pistol, I don't think you'll win a fight against the whole security force. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Good luck. I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches! Please, I know I've always been a jerk towards you. I know it! But you can't walk away and let her die just because I was an asshole. Please! I'm begging you! Sure, I don't care why. Just get her out of there. You to have my Tunnel Snakes jacket. Go ahead, take it.
This is the Overseer. All residents of Vault 101 are hereby confined to their quarters. The rat roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with vault security personnel. Any resident found out.
Hold it right there!
Missy, I just...
There's more. Over here.
Oh, good. I found
like that.
What with you now?
Teach you to mess with me.
That's enough excitement for one day. Ah, young man.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me!
Tom! Be careful!
Don't.
Officer, it's the Doc's kid.
Come and get it, you dirty traitor!
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young lady. You're already in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself. Oh, is that all? Is there anything else I can get you while you're here? You'll get nothing from me. I'll die before I see the safety of the vault compromised again. I've dealt with your kind before, you little snot-nosed punk. You should have run like your coward of a father. I knew you'd turn up sooner or later. How dare you, friend? I knew you'd turn up sooner or later.
Jonas, I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay. Go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
Trying to help me, but you didn't have to kill him. So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now. I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No, don't listen to me. Just go. Find your father. I have to go bury mine. No, I can't. Not with you, not now. You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.
Stop in the name of the overseer.
I'm not going out there.
welcome, sir or madam, to Crazy Wolfgang's Traveling Junk Store, the depot of detritus, the shop of slop, and the caravan of crap. Now, what odds and ends can I, the craziest of all possible Wolfgangs, offer to you? I scour the wasteland for the very best pieces of trash, the height of detritus, and the veritable pick of the litter. It's all valuable to someone. And I always make sure to make my rounds through Canterbury Commons. Their mayor, Roe, always has a place for a clever junk man like myself. Another satisfied customer. Whatever you've got, I've got just the thing to fix it. Good luck out there. And maybe next time, you'll find something interesting for me, huh?
Our great democracy. So, as your president, I am the voice. Galaxy News Radio, and I'm your host, the Red Dog, Lord and Master of all myself, hey. Watch out, scenes we've got, a bit of news, just listen to this. Here's a question for all you big fans. Have you guys and gals ever seen on screen? No, not those shriveled black things. I'm talking real.
Have yourself a nice visit, partner.
Photosynthesis, all that good stuff. Now what if I, the all-powerful three dog, Bow Wow Wow, were to tell you that somewhere right here in the capital wasteland is a place with lots of trees. A veritable oasis of green in that depressing sea of brown. Years ago, and I'll
be damned. Another newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, girl. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something. The quiet type, huh? Fine. Might help keep you out of trouble. I hope you're not a weirdo. Got enough of those already. God, I hope you ain't one of those psychotic quiet types. So, is there anything else I can do for you? Nope, sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town. It's called the Wasteland for a reason, but there are settlements too, spread all around. The human race is stubborn like that. To the south, you've got Rivet City, but don't bother going to DC. The place is a war zone. Mind your manners now.
You're that stray from the vault. I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you? Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy. Yeah, you wouldn't imagine how hard it is to replace that big light bulb up there, too. That's great for a foreword. Open with a joke and all that. Here, take the suit. Something tells me you might need it. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun. Let's see. Dealing with radiation, testing an experimental device, and, I won't lie, it may include some reading. That sort of stuff, you know? But for all that, I can pay you with caps, meds, chems, and maybe even a few of those unique inventions, if you do a good job. Interested? Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words. Caps, chems, meds, and maybe even a few unique inventions, if you do a good job. I'm sure I've got something that'll catch your eye. With a little ingenuity, you can turn a pile of junk into a mountain of caps. And there's no shortage of junk, so will you help out? Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first? Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books. But I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that. Oh, don't worry so much about it. I'll be here waiting with a nice tall glass of red cleansing Brahmin milk for you when you get back. Well, mostly just a whole lot of rad X and rad away. And maybe even a more reliable way to get rid of radiation. Assuming it works, of course. Oh, you're a peach. Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays. Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness, but if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of. Could be the guy I saw at Moriarty's saloon not too long ago. I'd ask there. Couldn't do that. It'd be a real blow to those nice folks in the church. Besides, it's not like that bomb ever hurt anyone. Live and let live, right? Absolutely. Good hunting. Try not to die.
Junk. Every day it's the same damn thing.
I told you, Gob, it ain't the radio. The Enclave station comes in fine. It's Galaxy News. Their signal's been shit lately.
Why won't you work? Come on. Son of a bitch. Stupid radio. Wait. Hey, Smoothskin. You need something? A drink, maybe? Anything? You ever seen a ghoul before? Well, not all of us got the chance to hole up in a nice cushy vault when the bombs fell. A bunch of us got stuck out here in the world and got a full-on blast of heat and radiation. Turned us into a pack of walking corpses. Near as I can tell, we age slower than you. A lot slower. There were even a few ghouls alive during the war. Of course, with a face like ground Brahmin meat, you can imagine that folks don't take too kindly to us. Nice of you to say so. If you can't be nice, at least pretend, right? Fake it till you make it and all that. Still, a fake compliment is better than the usual spit in the face that I get. You're not half bad for a smooth skin. Oh, yeah, I do remember a guy like that. Honestly, I usually keep my head down. I tend to get smacked around if I look customers in the eyes. But talk to Moriarty, he'll know more. Sorry, Smoothskin. I can't take the risk. Moriarty will beat the shit out of me for even talking to you. Oh, man, I'm glad to see you. Moriarty's been especially nasty lately. And I need a friendly face. Mr. Moriarty says we can keep it on. It's a good radio station. I like hearing the DJ, Three Dog, and how he's helping to fight the good fight. If only I was a part of that, instead of being stuck in this dive. place called Underworld. It's a ghoul city down in D.C. I set off up here to find adventure and fortune. And, well, I found this place.
I'm sort of stuck here. Colin says that I can't leave until I pay off my debt to him. Of course, he charges me room and board, too. If you ever get to Underworld, tell Carol that I said hi. See you soon.
Good to see you.
I don't recognize you. New in town or something? I do. I'm looking for someone to make a delivery. Interested? Hey, you're pretty smart for a wastelander. I need you to deliver a message to my family. They live in a small settlement northwest of here. If you bring it, I'm sure my dad will pay you. I'll tell you more if you agree. Please, I could really use your help. Actually, I don't have any caps with me. I used everything I had buying a shack in this town. But if you'd be nice enough to help me, I bet my father would pay you something for all the trip. What do you say? Great. I'd like you to deliver this message to my family in the Arafu settlement. I haven't heard from them in months, and I'm worried. As soon as you get there, talk to Davis West. He'll be glad to pay you for the trip. Sure. Be glad to, since you're doing me a big favor and all. Arafu is northwest of Megaton, on an old overpass over the Potomac. If you follow what's left of the river, you can't miss it. Okay. Hey, thanks again for doing this for me. It means a lot.
My, my. Just when I'd all but given up hope. My dear girl, I'm very happy to make your acquaintance. I am Mr. Burke. And you, well, you are not a resident of this putrescent cesspool. That makes you a rather valuable individual. As you wish. I'm looking to employ an individual with no ties to Megaton, no interest in its future. Megaton is obsolete, the last vestige of a cobbled, desperate past. It needs to go away, and you are going to see that it does. No, no. I'm merely a recruiter. You get to have the real fun. The undetonated atomic bomb for which this town is named is still very much alive. All it needs is a little motivation. I have in my possession a fusion pulse charge. Once rigged to the bomb, it will be detonated by you at a secure location. Easy money, my friend. Color me intrigued. Go on. Well, I mean, of course not. I must admit, I've never met a woman quite like you before. This changes everything. I'm not sure what I'm going to tell Tenpenny. I'll think of something. You wait here, my dear. I have some important business to attend to, but you won't be waiting long. I shall send for you soon.
Looking for you. Rest will cost you.
Yeah, what the hell do you want? Colin Moriarty, at your service. Welcome to Moriarty's. My saloon, my home, my slice of heaven in this backwoods little burg. You've got the caps, I've got your pleasure. Please sit down, make yourself comfortable. Your troubles are a thing of the past.
God, it's you. The little baby girl, all grown up. Persistent little flower, ain't you? Then and now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid.
Oh, your daddy passed through here, all right. Here and gone. Look what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct? You seem like a nice kid, so I'm going to be straight with you. Your dad was here, and now he's not. And yes, I know where he went. But what you're asking me for is information, and information is a commodity. Let's say 100 cops, and daddy's location is yours. Very reasonable. All right, kid. Let me help you out. You know, for all time's sake. If you don't have the cops to pay for the information, then maybe you could do a little favor for me. Fine. Go find Daddy yourself, then. I'll be here when you change your mind. Don't let me keep you.
Problem? Looking free. The rest will cost ya.
Knock down the door. Weighs like 13 tons.